Sometimes caffeine is a bad self-medicating drug causing all sorts of problems, but other times it can be really good for your brains. Hey y'all, Trace here for DNews, helping to validate your coffee, tea, and chocolate addictions. What do they have in common? Caffeine. Caffeine is an uber popular stimulant that people self-medicate with all the time. Thanks to its proliferation, scientists have been studying this little molecule for a while. We know it boosts people's feelings of alertness, slows dopamine reabsorption, and now we've got another bonus, memory consolidation. Memory consolidation is the moving of information from the 20 to 30 second short-term memory to the long-term memory. It's not the same as memory retention, which is the ability to recall a specific bit of information. Consolidation is usually thought to take place during sleep, and a new study in the journal Nature Neuroscience explores how caffeine could add to this process. The researchers showed non-caffeine consumers a set of pictures, and then afterward gave them either a 200 milligram caffeine pill or a placebo. 200 milligrams is about what's in a 16 ounce cup of coffee. The reason they didn't give it to them before the test is they weren't testing memory retention, but memory consolidation. They wanted to be sure the caffeine didn't affect the people's test-taking ability, but instead affected if they forgot things. 24 hours later, the same participants were shown another set of pictures and were asked to identify which were in the second set and the first. To stimulate a certain brain process called pattern separation, a deeper process than simple memorization, the second set was similar, but not quite the same as the first. The results indicated that those who took the caffeine pill forgot less and were better at picking out the new photos, showing caffeine helped, although they're not sure why. So back to the lab, ho! The practical takeaway is you can help tell your brain to remember a specific event or maybe a bit of information if afterward you just get a little bit of caffeine. It's sort of like highlighting a piece of your memory. Maybe if you do that, your brain will include it in tonight's consolidation. The half-life of caffeine is about 6 hours. So if you were to drink the 200 milligrams of caffeine that they're recommending for like a 10 p.m. study group session, there would still be 100 milligrams in your body at 4 a.m. That can affect sleep quality, so maybe it's better to try this during the day. Just saying. I may have to do some self-experimentation to see how caffeine boosts my own memory. I already know it does wonders for my attention span, and if your attention span is as short as mine, you'll probably dig Scott Bromley's internet rabbit hole, a brand new show launched on our sister network, Rev3 Games. Scott will take you on a fast-paced journey through pop culture to prove how everything on the internet is completely connected, if you know where to look.
If Pac-Man was never invented, Christian Bale would have never been Batman.
Check out every Tuesday, and if you like it, why not subscribe? Anyway, what were we talking about? Oh, right, memory. So how's yours? Mine is pretty bad about a lot of things. I can't remember what I even had for breakfast last Friday. No idea. But I remember all sorts of stupid trivia, so tell me about it down below, and that's what those boxes are for. Also, subscribe now. You might forget later.